came to California. He was 21 years old, as I recall. He loved to write a song and pick the guitar, and he came to hang a gold one on the wall. The town which he lived is not important, but you'll know which town I mean by the time I'm through. He soon became a famous entertainer, but Leonard was a name he never used. He was on his way to having what he wanted, just about as close as one could be. Hey, once he even followed Elvis Presley, and he wrote a lot of country songs for me. But he laid it all aside to follow Jesus. For years he chose to let his music go, but preaching wasn't really meant for Leonard. But how in the hell was Leonard supposed to know? Well, life began to twist its way around him, and I wondered how he carried such a load. He came back again to try his luck in music, and lost his wife and family on the road. After that, he seemed to bog down even deeper, and I saw what booze and pills can really do. And I wondered if I'd ever see him sober. But I'd forgot about a friend that Leonard knew. Well, Leonard gave me lots of inspiration. He helped teach me how to write a country song, and he even brought around a bag of groceries, hey, back before Muskogee came along. Really, I'm not trying to hide his show name or the town in which this episode began. Somehow I had to write a song for old Tommy, if just to see the smiling faces in the band. Well, when Leonard finally came to California, he was 21 years old, as I recall. And he loved to write a song and pick the guitar, and he came to hang a gold one on the wall.